So disease as per the Rashi / Ascendant. So what this list talks about, this list tells us that Aries indicates baggage, blood impurities, heart ailments, pain in head, pain in stomach, pain in sexual organs. Right? This happens when Aries is afflicted. When there is a malefic in Aries, natural malefic, functional malefic both. And also when someone is born in Aries ascendant, someone is having his moon in Aries and sun in Aries. Moon and sun are also considered as an ascendant. This you know. So it is also applicable for moon ascendant and the sun ascendant. This point is pretty clear. We'll go further into it. Taurus indicates diabetes, sexual disease, polyuria, diseases of throat and heart, piles, boils and pimples in sexual organs, epilepsy. What does this polyuria means? I myself don't know. Okay. Because I think in Hindi then write in English. So I translated it using a software. You translate it back. Right. Gemini indicates sexual disease, fistula, piles, issues in nervous system, weakness and problems in hands and stomach. Cancer indicates wounds in bones, tuberculosis, liver issues, hysteria, madness, insanity, diseases arising out of climate change. You know, regular cough and cold. Weakness of digestion, gastric trouble, dropsy, mental weakness, crofula. This will be there when the Aries, when these Rashis are afflicted. So malefics, natural malefics will make it afflicted. Functional malefics, 6th Lord, 8th Lord, 12th Lord in this sign will make it afflicted. When these Rashis are in Lagna, Cancer ascendant, Moon in Cancer, Sun in Cancer, then this disease is supposed to happen. Right. Also, when this sign is in the sixth house, when the Cancer is in the sixth house, then also this problem is supposed to be there. So generally for Aquarius Lagna person, Cancer will be in the sixth house. So Aquarius Lagna is susceptible to weakness of digestion, susceptible to mental weakness, suspected to scrofula, subjected to gastric troubles, etc. Right. This is pretty clear. No confusion about it. There is a confusion, you will stop me and ask me the question. Going to the next signs, Leo indicates blockages in blood flow, diseases of cold, sweating, skin issues, constipation, blood pressure, epilepsy, backache and swelling. Virgo indicates a lot of heat, so that results in fever, etc. Lack of blood, eye ailments, stomach ailments, obesity, obstruction of excretion, colon problems, slow digestion, and diseases arising out of imbalance of bile, phlegm, and air, weak intestine. When we say diseases arising out of imbalance of bile, phlegm, and air, this basically means diseases coming out of the person not keeping a good lifestyle, not keeping a balanced food. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर आप सोचो कि मैं आज से चावल खाना छोड़ दूंगा सो वन न्यूट्रिएंट इज मिसिंग फ्रॉम योर फूड दैट विल क्रिएट अ प्रॉब्लम दैट इज द अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ इम्बैलेंस ऑफ बाइल फ्लेगम एंड एयर इम्बैलेंस ऑफ वात पित्त एंड कफ लिब्रा इंडिकेट्स इचिंग गाउट डिसेंट्री डायरिया डायबिटीज स्किन डिसऑर्डर्स एंड जनरल वीकनेस Scorpio indicate headache, sleeplessness, diseases of eyes and mouth, sexual disease, premature ejaculation, problem in throat, infectious disease, insanity because of intoxication, etc. Sagittarius indicates the person being nymphomaniac, that is doing a lot of sexual activities and weakness arising out of that. Nightfall, throat ailments, breathing issues, swelling, boils and pimples, bone ailments, bone marrow issues, and fever. Capricorn indicate lung ailments, asthma, cough, bone marrow related ailments. Weak body, increase of coldness, windy complaints, pain in legs and pneumonia. Aquarius will indicate stomach problems, intestinal problems, windy complaints, convulsion in stomach, pet mein marod patna. Lack of blood, sprain, eye disease, weakness of liver, weakness of legs and new diseases like corona. Right, so no one knew corona before 2018, right? New disease. Pisces indicates weakness of heart. We can lead to stroke, heart attack, etc. diseases arising out of not following the schedule, sleeping late, waking up early, that kind of scenario. Ascites, too much of sweating, nervousness, infectious diseases, and diseases arising out of intoxicants. Okay. Clear up to this extent? Now, one more point is there, one major point that you have to keep in mind. Cancer indicate heart, because cancer is the natural fourth house. Right, and fourth house indicates the heart. We have covered this in the first class or not? We covered this in the first class, right? Which house is, which rashi indicates which body part we covered. So because cancer is the fourth house, that indicates heart, okay? Okay. Now moon is the significator of mind. So moon will indicate mental disease. And when moon is afflicted, it will indicate mental disease, okay? Right, that's fine. But the own rashi of moon is cancer. Moon is exalted in Taurus. Moon is debilitated in Scorpio. Right? So these three signs will also indicate mental issues. Getting my point? The disease of the planet, the disease that the planet indicates, is not only signified by that planet, but is also signified by the rashi of the planet. The rashi where the planet is exalted and the rashi where the planet is debilitated also. This you have to keep in mind. Okay. Good. We'll go further. In the next page, this is rashi disease. Now this disease only happens when this rashi falls in the sixth house. Or when this rashi is afflicted. Only in these two conditions, these diseases will come. Okay? So you see, when Aries becomes the ascendant, there is no problem related to bone marrow. Right? When Aries becomes the ascendant, there is no bone marrow problem. But when Aries becomes the sixth house, there comes bone marrow problem. Are you getting my point? So we are being very pinpointed about it. Aries as Lagna, Aries afflicted as Lagna, etc. will not cause bone marrow problem. Only Aries being in the sixth house or Aries being the Rashi where sixth lord is situated or Aries receiving the aspect of the sixth lord only will create this problem. So this second list only indicate those diseases which planet will cause when they afflict a Rashi as the sixth lord, or when these Rashi themselves fall in the sixth house and there is a differentiation. Are we clear about it? Difference is there. Don't confuse. Okay. This is clear. Headache, sleeplessness, diseases of eyes and mouth. If you see, sleeplessness is not a problem of Aries ascendant. It is a problem of Aries in the sixth house, right? So new diseases. Right, this segregation is very important. Taurus indicates throat element, headache, problems related to urination and problems related to urination in sleep. Now, kuch logo sote bathroom kar dete hain. Gemini indicates problem in legs, asthma, blood ailments and white leprosy. Cancer indicates stomach ailments, digestion issues, obesity, windy complaints. Just a second. Cancer indicates stomach ailments, digestion issues, obesity, and windy complaints as a sixth house. Okay. Cancer will become sixth house for Aquarius ascendant. And in Aquarius, you find the mention of convulsions in stomach problems, intestinal problems, windy complaints. Are you getting my point? Aquarius Lagna indicates these diseases and the sixth house will be cancer. Cancer also indicates these diseases. So stomach related issues, digestion issues and windy complaints come to an Aquarius person because of the cancer being in the sixth house, right? Okay. Leo indicates diseases arising out of irregular lifestyle, blood ailments and heart diseases. Virgo indicates constipation, stomach ache, gooseberry and hunchback, the person being hunched back and constipation. Hunched back means problem in the formation of the body. Virgo indicates problem in the bodily formation itself. Libra indicates diabetes, polyuria, and sexual diseases. Scorpio indicates fissure, pain in sexual organs, irritation in sexual organs. Sagittarius indicates pain or break in bones and joints, tuberculosis, blood impurities, liver issues, and hysteria. Capricorn indicates cold issues, problems in blood flow, skin disorders, constipation, and loss or lack of taste. Aquarius indicates mental disease, lack of blood, eye ailments, stiffness, whereas Pisces indicates itching, disgusting disease, guilty, gooseberry, gout. Disgusting disease, what is disgusting disease? So sometimes you get such a disease, you know, that people don't want to come near you. Like HIV AIDS looks disgusting, na? People don't want to come near you. There is a mental tendency. Though AIDS chhune se to nahi phailta. Right? It is not a transmissible disease by touching, but still people want to stay aloof from such a person or not. So, you know, there are some disease, koi bimari hoti na, wo haath se mawad nikalne lagta hai, khun behne lagta hai, to aadmi kareeb nahi aana chahta, right? There are few diseases, there are few wounds where some things are flowing out of body and then people don't want to come near you. That is disgusting disease for Pisces. This is indicated through Pisces. Getting my point? And this second list is only applicable when this Rashi is activated by being connected to sixth house in any matter. Whereas the first table generally works on this Rashi being the Lagna, Bharat Lagna, Sun Lagna, Moon Lagna, and Navamsh Lagna, right? So this differentiation you have to be very clear about. You cannot confuse it, okay? Good. Good. Now the third list, Rashi-based disease. So this is the table, you will note it down. So the Aries indicates external organ head, internal organ mouth, and bones temple of forehead. This particular area, you know, this bone behind the ear. So every Rashi will indicate one external organ, one internal organ, and one bone. That is given as a list. Right, Taurus indicates external organ face, internal organ throat, and the bone of neck. You try to understand the point now. The internal throat is Taurus. The external throat is Gemini. Agar koi gala kaat dega, so it is a problem of Gemini. If someone slits your throat, that is a Gemini problem. If you get throat cancer, that is a Taurus problem. Are you getting my point? Clear and precise we have to be. External, internal relationship.
So this Rashi based disease is as per the Rashi Lagna or as per the sixth house?
This is as per affliction.
Affliction.
As per affliction. So when these are afflicted, specifically affliction through sub-planets like Guli Kumandi. Okay, and it indicates the Taurus indicates the neck bone. Gemini indicates the shoulder, throat, and hands bone. Cancer indicates external chest, internal chest, womb, and the bones of chest and the bones of womb. So if the lady is not able to conceive a child, the problem is related to cancer. Though Leo indicates stomach, but childlessness is a problem of cancer. The lord of cancer is moon, that indicates mother, no? Your capability to become a mother. Leo indicates heart externally, skeleton internally, the complete skeletal system is Leo. Why sun indicates bone? Bone signified by Saturn, and sun is the biggest enemy of Saturn. That's why sun creates problem in bones. This we have learned in the previous class, if I am right. And it indicates the back bones. Virgo indicates stomach externally, intestine internally, and the backbone. Libra indicates external waist, internal anus, and waist, the bones of waist. Scorpio externally indicates sexual organs, internally indicates anus and sexual organs, and indicates the bones of hip. Now, basically, there is no bone in hip. So the muscles of hip, basically. Sagittarius indicates thighs externally, back internally, and the bone of thighs. Capricorn indicates knees externally, knees internally, and the bone of knees. Aquarius indicates legs externally, legs internally, and the legs bone also. Pisces indicates external feet, sole of the feet, and the bones of ankles. This is affliction. Okay. And if you have, through this explanation, if you have just checked your chart, sir, this falls in my sixth house and this is my lagna, I'm pretty sure you must have found 2-3 diseases that you have got in your life. Everyone gets disease then and there, you know, sometime in life, keep on getting diseases.